he will be taking charge for a 3-year term. He, being the insider, will find almost all the things quite familiar. He has worked with the bank for more than 3 decades. Prior to being chairman, he was working as managing director of the portfolio of global banking, that is the international banking arm of business, and the subsidiaries and associate as one. So for last 4 years, he has been with this particular portfolio. He did a very biggest exercise of merging 5 of the associate banks with the mother, that is the SBI. So he has got a all-round experience of being in organization restructuring, then running specific like retail banking, then your biz corporate, and then now the heading at the board level. And he comes at a time when the economy is in gradually unlocking itself. So he has two important priorities before him. As you have seen in the last 6 months, all the banks, though they have kept their operations going, the loan growth has been very subdued because of the lack of demand and people becoming cautious about their spending. Gradually, he has to increase the loan book because the earnings for the bank predominantly come from interest income. While doing so, he also has to keep eye on maintaining the quality of the loan book. That is, the chances of that going default or bad loans should be minimized. Here we cannot speak about completely eliminating it because it's a very complex and a very risky environment that we are getting into. All the banking sector and the SBI have been able to maintain the operations, especially the branches and the backbone, up and running in a safe manner. So continuing that till the pandemic recedes and we get a very secure environment, that would be the first priority. Second would be, that is, while doing so, you require to give a lot of support and motivation to the staff. So nurturing and managing the human resources is very crucial. In the case of SBI, they have just announced an intention for a voluntary retirement scheme from December onwards. So many people will perhaps go, and that number would be quite large. So how to get new people into the new assignments, relocating various functions, all this also will be very crucial. The second. Third is, that is, as you are aware, in order to give some kind of a relief for the people who are impacted by COVID, RBI came with a restructuring scheme for the existing loans, those who are impacted by the COVID. So that's a very gigantic task on the retail side, the medium and small enterprises, and large companies. All three have been given an option of restructuring. So carrying that out is a very important thing. Also, the bank carries the previous bad loans, their resolution, so that the incidence of bad loans which are currently on the book also come down. That is the third one. And fourth would be on the risk management. Risk management from the point of view, that is, as the economy gradually comes up, which are the sectors which will give up more opportunity, which are the sectors which are still risky, so you have to keep your exposure limited. All that exercise is under the risk management. And finally, everyone is now aware that how the digitization and digital banking has played role in this 6 months. So you were able to carry out your very crucial banking needs and requirements. After getting that lesson, the bank has a responsibility to maintain that edge. You might have heard of the banking app that they have, YONO. Now, this is very successful and effective product that they have come out. but other banks are not going to sit tight and pretty. They will also come with their products and give a competition. So SBI has a lead or edge that they will have to continuously work on it, innovate, bring new products, new services. These are the five priorities that he will have to do or look at.
If you like this video, share it and subscribe to Business Standard. For more news, views and insights, log on to www.business-standard.com. Do also follow us on YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, Telegram and LinkedIn.